really what I want to talk about is sort of the current state of community development, where we are in the community, why we're doing this, and where we're going from here. I think we've had a really good start. How do we capitalize on this and push forward even further? So it's really sort of a state of where we are now, and state of where we'd like to be in the future. So we removed the slide from yesterday, where I was basically talking about as far as why we're doing this, when you look at this new technology and you look at how things change, and the days that it's changing and how it's accelerated, and you get a hot new technology that wants to use immediately to start getting adoption and deployment, and then at some point along the way it becomes clear that this stuff is really in a state. Look at the previous history of how things changed in the beginning of development. Linux, I still remember when Linux was something that was functioned as a small print server, but not for the distribution. I still remember when virtualization was the developer's tool. I still remember when cloud was something that was never going to be used by anything substantial. Right? We all know that those things changed. Docker. So all these things are going to at some point forward. And because of rapid change, that's why we're talking about open source technology. When you look at the current space of cloud management, there is another open source company platform. And so I think Jared said it best in one of the podcasts we did last week, in that customers are demanding open source software, cloud-based software, because it's the only thing that really can keep up. Look at, so when I put vision customer here because that really was a transformation that occurred when it came to software. It became a way for customers to engage on the same level as everyone else. Traditionally, the vendor was up here, the customer was down here, and one of the people. The difference at the first stage is now they're on the same footing, and they're fine with it. Or, multiple vendors, multiple customers, multiple partners, and they have to do that. apologize on two fronts. You see the honor panel and the that was a standard point. You guys have to like show me these things that I don't. They are a service provider in Australia. What's that? Apparently, yes. Yeah, they're a service provider. So what we want to do is enable customer communication to reignite. One of the reasons that all this design is coming together is to get about enabling the process. It can be but we also want to increase the reach of the fellowship. We can't have a successful community that's just. It's got to be bigger. I remember when I went to Gloucester and I was in the choir. Actually, yesterday, I'll never forget part of the thing. You said it. It's great that you're doing the same stuff, but you've got to make it bigger. So when you look at the Red Hat model, it's all based on the usual table. Software is produced by large dynamic teams. We bring it down to the product that is demonstrated. And that's how you do it. I like to avoid that because, again, there's no innovation happening in the brain. You can't just come in and do whatever you want, and then if it doesn't work, you don't have to deal. That doesn't work in the same way because, again, it's all defined by so the best way I can think of to capture the happenstance of innovation is to have a moment where everyone feels empowered. Necessarily translate into the product. If you have a place where any engineer can make it start to start to kind of code, you want to be in a place that is not necessarily functional. that's kind of what I'm proposing. Maybe a down payment. Website companies, documentation. Are you actually changing that? Obviously, I don't know. So if you look at the way it's currently structured, our website is based on the middle land, and then the contact information. You provide So we were just talking about that one. It's looking like. So next one, the next one is spring. Where would you like to stay? One question. So the open question right now is, do we keep it as a standalone thing where it's the ManageIQ platform, or do we co-locate it with the platform? I mean, that's like the open question. What's that? We'll take that discussion with Paul. About it and argue. You know what? We're gonna start a thread on this as to when and where for the next design. Oh, I hate Paul Stone. I got smacked by the brand news. There's only one set of thunder that. But we'll open up.